It was said in the comments on my last video that the alt-right, the far-right, and the hardcore anti-SJWs have been in decline since 2018. And my retort to that is, no, they haven't been in decline. They've become more popular. They've become more mainstream. And once something becomes more mainstream, there's no need to scream it so loudly. Those kinds of views have been making their way into mainstream conservatism. Conservatism was starting to become more LGBT-friendly, but that's changing. Homosexuality is getting labeled by many people as degeneracy. Homosexuals who are out of the closet, like myself, or anyone who feels that they're part of the LGBT community, are getting put in the same category as those who want to confuse 7-year-olds by forcing elementary schools to teach kids about gender identity. And we're put into the same category as people who want to label pedophiles as minor attracted persons. These kinds of views of LGBT have increased by a tenfold since Trump was in office. Now, I'm not going to say that it's Trump's fault directly, but some of his followers? I mean, the people who essentially say, "Trump said it, I believe it, that settles it." Those kind of people certainly contribute to this. Most of them are really religious, and they've found a way, through Trump, to combine their religious beliefs with politics. Patriot prayers, after all, right? No, nothing religious about that. Degenerates! You hate America! Look, there are many reasons why anti-gay sentiment, anti-LGBT sentiment, is on the rise. If we don't talk about both sides of why those things are rising, it's just going to continue to get worse. The fact that some of these kinds of views are becoming mainstream conservative views is why it's become very difficult for tech companies to try to moderate these kinds of ugly viewpoints. Again, I'm not trying to say that these kinds of viewpoints should be silenced, just that big tech companies are trying to silence them. You know, I'm just taking note of it, taking note of what they're trying to do. Companies like Twitter have pretty much just said it. If they try to moderate these kinds of viewpoints, it's going to disproportionately affect a lot of people who are just conservative, who do not identify as alt-right or far-right, or even hardcore anti-SJWs. One of the big problems is that conservatives are not calling out these ugly viewpoints. They might once in a while say, "Yeah, yeah, those people are bad, yeah, 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 but look at the left!" Instead of calling out these viewpoints, they're pretty much defending them at every turn. Every time those kinds of views get silenced on some sort of tech platform, they're there defending them. And yet I don't see them defending when left-wingers get censored. No defense there. No, no, it's the right. The right's being censored. Well, yes, the right is being censored more because the right is putting out these views more often. I mean, I don't ever see the left putting out those kinds of views. The left has their own brand of crazy, and sometimes they get censored, and I don't see people on the right defending them. I mean, really, how is that supposed to work? How can you claim you're for the principle of free speech, but the only people you defend are the nasty people that are coming from the far right? Don't we want leftists to call out the far left? So why is it suddenly different when it's the right wing? Why shouldn't we expect the right wing to call this stuff out? Could it be that many of them actually support these kinds of ideas? I don't know the answer to that. I just know that these kinds of ugly beliefs are spreading like wildfire, and right-wingers are defending them at every turn. You've got the biological imperative people like Black Pigeon Speaks, and you have the people declaring that LGBT are a bunch of degenerates from people like Red Elephants, and the amazing Lucas, and PragerU, and Paul Joseph Watson, and Candace Owens, and Diamond and Silk, and The Daily Wire with Ben Shapiro, Matt Walsh, and Michael Knowles. And then you have all the people between. But it's all coming from the right. And those of us on the left, we're not supposed to be concerned about any of it. We're not supposed to be concerned about the rise of this.
Mega.
We're watching everyone become more judgmental, and we're not supposed to have any concern over it. We're just supposed to join one gang or the other and be happy with it, right? Now, this is not saying that Trump is directly at fault for this. Trump isn't saying, oh, people, go out and do this stuff. But he certainly isn't doing anything to try to stop the rise of this kind of mindset. Anyway, I guess I've said enough.